And we were able to pick a couple of pillars that we needed to invest in. The one thing that came out very strongly from the review by McKinsey was we had 5.7 million customers from various sectors, but we had only most of those customers, about 71%, had only one product in the bank, and there was incredible opportunity for cross-selling of those customers. And so we, one of the things that we did beginning of this year is to change the business model from a product-centric model to a customer-centric model. We have then taken time also to invest in the branch transformation. The branch transformation, we have managed successfully to push 72% of our transactions in the branches to alternative channels, meaning only 28% of the customer's transactions are now being done at the branches. It's incredible. We've then invested in a Salesforce effectiveness that has been very powerful in terms of then mining more business from those customers. We've been able then to realign the customer service, and by 9 months, we have a profit before tax of 12.1 billion. That's an incredible 33% growth from the 9 billion that we had September last year.
In terms of projections, you've spoken about the NPLs, you anticipated it could go up. But the government has said they expect interest rates really to come down. Do you think that's going to be possible in the near future?
I think what I want to say is interest rates are coming down, which is very good. Yesterday, the interbank rate was 10.2%, so interest rates are coming down, which is good for the industry.